come from all over the country every year to meet at their national convention. Their kinsmen, young men between the ages of 21 and 40, diverse in their actions, thoughts, and backgrounds, involved in their communities. Kinsmen is Canada's all-Canadian service club with thousands of members in hundreds of clubs across Canada. KIN is the fastest growing service club in the country. An annual convention is a must to conduct important business, form new friendships, renew old friendships, and to chart the future. Fellowship and kinship are two important watchwords at any national convention, and the point is made right in the club's name, KIN. KIN is, above all, people from all walks of life enjoying themselves.
Ready for the next one.
One of the main items on the agenda at National Convention is a State of the Union message on KIN projects and involvements across the country. No convention would be complete either without its colorful campaigning for the office of National Vice President and the installation of new officers. National Convention is also a time when many people come together to talk about the problems and the role of service clubs, especially in terms of fulfilling the KIN slogan, serving the community's greatest need. It's also an appropriate time for the clubs to assess their value to the community as a whole. KIN clubs raise money for community needs, more money than any other service group. In fact, they raise approximately $8 million every year, and they do it in a wide assortment of projects, auctions, fairs, hockey games, car draws, or lotteries.
For the presentation of the $50,000 first prize in KIN Lottery D, and to present the check from the Governor of District 1, Mr. Bruce Crozier.
Mr. Sabat, on behalf of KIN Lottery, it's a great pleasure for me to give you this check for $50,000.
Thank you.
With lotteries, there are big prizes, big amounts of public participation, and big dividends for KIN projects supported by the funds raised. Meanwhile, back at the convention, the fun goes on. These are all kinsmen, kin wives, or kinettes. The feeling is that while they work hard, they can play with the best of them and make their own fun. It's hard to argue with. But just as there is time to look into the future, kinsmen find the time to look back at what they've done and where they've been. Hal Rogers, founder of KIN, first had the idea in 1920 that there was a community need unserved and that the social energies of young men between 21 and 40 were going untapped. Since then, KIN has flourished and grown into an involved family organization with Kinettes, the women's group, K40 and Kettes for the veterans of the movement, and KIN 20 for young people under 21 years of age. KIN accomplishments are many things to many communities across Canada. The new swimming pool down the street, the baseball diamond, the new wing on the hospital, the recreation center, the annual carnival, Sunday drives for crippled children and the elderly, summer camps for underprivileged children, retarded children's workshops, to name a few. KINSMEN is a national association which recognizes that its strength lies not only in numbers, but in individuals. KINSMEN clubs pride themselves in being flexible and self-governing. It is through this forum that the KINSMEN club in each community can best adapt itself to serve and become involved in that community's greatest need.
To everything, time.
also people enjoying themselves. And there has been every kind of gag, prank, funny costume, presentation, corn roast, or what have you. But above all, there has been the vision of one man and the energies of thousands putting that vision into daily practice. People is important to a kinsman. So is having a good time. When you can combine the two by running a fundraising project like a beer garden and join the festivities yourself, everybody wins.
This opportunity of welcoming you all to the Kinsman Club of Toronto Monday Night Bingo at the Broom and Stone.
Bingo is a big service project, and some of the biggest bingos are run by kin clubs across the country. The prizes are big, and so, again, are the funds generated for community projects. There's another bonus, too. Like many other kin projects, it gives kinsmen a chance to get experience handling big operations. It has been said that membership in kin is like a management course, a public relations seminar, a term in politics, and a career as a social worker, all rolled up into one. One of the greatest needs of our national community has been a resource and training facility to deal with the problems of the mentally retarded. Many kin clubs have been aware of this problem and have been actively working with the retarded in their own communities. The need for a national institute for the correlation of field programs and research led to kinsmen throughout Canada assisting in the funding of the Kinsmen National Institute for the Mentally Retarded. The project was completed in 1970 as a Kinsman 50th anniversary project at a cost of $400,000. That's a lot of money. However, during this same period, Kinsman clubs throughout Canada raised over $50 million for projects in their own communities also. The Institute is recognized as being one of the most up-to-date facilities of its type in the world. There is a modern audio-visual section which produces teaching programs, workshop materials, and research tapes which are disseminated across the country. In effect, this is the resource center for professionals from all over the country who put programs into effect following the experience of the Institute's projects. Often, demonstrations of therapy or other programs are videotaped and played back for various groups of professionals who gauge where the programs can be refined and adapted for uses across the country. Then, teaching aids can be assembled and shipped out to regional centers. Of course, the Institute also works as a feedback center, working on the findings of field groups who continually upgrade services. Many clubs assist with sheltered workshops and other facilities working directly with the mentally retarded in their communities. Many of the crafts and other projects turned out at these workshops have widespread appeal and considerable annual sales volume. Also at the local level, many kinsmen clubs provide financial assistance for people working with the mentally retarded in their own communities to attend training sessions and seminars held at the Kinsmen National Institute in Toronto. The main point is that KIN supports a national institute which works out to the local community level, where KIN locally can play a vital part in serving a need in the community. When you get right down to it, what makes a person join KIN? There are probably as many reasons as there are members, but mainly, it's a combination of fellowship, a chance for self-education and betterment through involvement, a chance for accomplishment, and just plain getting the most out of life. As one kinsman put it, you get a feeling that you're contributing, not just money, but a part of yourself, and you're learning in return. You see that you're getting something done in concrete terms. Something for your community, the national community, and the world community. The interaction of people working together is the central idea of kinsmanship. Kin is a word of relationship. That's what we're all about.